Well, the play is called Middle of the Night by Paddy Chayefsky. I'd heard of him, I'd never heard of it, although it was a TV play first, and then a Broadway play, and then a movie. It's a real honey of a play and of a part as well. A middle-aged man in the 50s who feels he's getting old, like middle-aged men in the 50s did, I guess. He's in his 50s, but death and dying and hospitalization and retirement seems to be swirling around his head. He's sort of thrown together with a young woman who works for him, who's homesick that day. It's quite beautifully arranged by Chayefsky. And a May-November romance ensues. Both of the characters, the young girl and the manufacturer, are second-timers. They're both of them. She's in a marriage she's getting out of, and he's a widower. It's the second time around for them each. It's beautifully told because of what he leaves out, and he leaves out almost everything that you think he'd keep in, like how they fall in love and where they fall in love. That just happens, and what you're left with is the reactions of the families and the community, in a way, to this age difference and the idea that they want to get married. It's very human. It's a play written about the kind of people you see on the subway that you don't even necessarily wonder about as having full, rich lives. That's who he writes about. The character's named the manufacturer. The girl is named the girl. The characters behave in very satisfyingly unexpected ways throughout. It's always a step ahead of you, which lends it this air of suspense, and it's not a suspense play at all. You just care about the characters and what's going to happen to them. The character works in the garment business. He's a partner in a not enormous firm. He's doing well. But that's not what's at stake. What's at stake is what's in his heart and her heart. It's personal and private and human. Everybody understands it on some level.